everything is not as it's sold. But the more I grow, the less I know. And I only saw many lies, though I'm not alone. And the more I see, the less I grow. The fewer the seeds, the more I sow. When I see you standing there, wanting more from me, and all I can do is try. When I see you standing there, wanting more from me, and all I can do is try. Try. I wish I hadn't seen all of the realness and all the real people are really not real at all. The more I
learn,
the more I cry. I say goodbye to a way of life I thought I had designed for me. Then I see you standing there, wanting more from me, and all I can do is try. Then I see you standing there, I'm all I'll ever be, but all I can do is try.
Don't go away because we're going to have a break and we're coming back to talk to Nelly. I love your videos.
Thank you.
You always have such great dignity because you let the music speak for you. You don't go there and let it all hang out. There's never any boobies or bum. I like that. No, that's
boobies
good.
Boobies or bum. Yeah.
That's good.
Thank you. Thank you.
Really. It's all about the music.
Yeah. I like it that way. I guess I prefer to shake your soul, you know?
Yeah.
A little bit. I guess my style is different. I kind of like to focus on, you know, the spiritual side, the intellectual side, rather than the all the time, you know?
Now, tell me, what
was
this...
Women have a lot to offer.
Other than their boobies and bums, definitely, yes. Oh, yeah. Now, what was the situation with you and FHM magazine in England, where they ran pictures of you, but they put your head on somebody else's body?
Well, it's kind of funny. I guess some people misunderstood the story, but I didn't do a photo shoot with them at all. And I guess they stuck me on the cover of the magazine and said, Nelly's hottest shoot yet. And I was like, okay.
Oh, thank you.
I purposely, you know, try not to do those types of magazines. I don't like the editorial. I find it demeaning. And basically, they not only stuck my picture on, but they chose a photo and then, like, altered it to make it look like I was wearing something different. It was just sort of salt on the wounds a little bit. So I just wanted my fans, at that time, this happened a couple of years ago, to let them know that I hadn't made that choice for myself. So when someone takes your power away in that way, it can affect you a certain way, you know?
Well, it's unbelievable that you don't have the right to stop something like that. And so they can take your image whatever way they want and just, you know, put your head on somebody else's body or whatever.
Yeah, nowadays, I was just on the internet and I saw I had a shirt on with it was like a different picture on the t-shirt I was wearing even that when I had originally taken that photo. So nowadays you just kind of gotta, you know, I have faith that my music is good and that my fans like my music and like me for who I am, and then all the other stuff I let, you know, it roll off my shoulders.
But it is annoying still though, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm sure you've had a lot of those things happen to you.
I wish. No, it never happens to me. No. I'm still waiting.
Oh, yeah, right. I don't believe you.
It's
I don't
true.
Believe you.
All right, try. It's such a great title because it can mean so many things.
Yeah.
But your track, Try, what does it mean to you?
You know, it means, it's just kind of about love. It's like a love story where I think when you love somebody and they love you, you're always trying to be a better person for that person and you never really get there, but it's that trying that defines love, wouldn't you say? So,
well, we all try and make ourselves better for the one we love. I think it's an unreachable goal.
Yeah,
somehow.
It is, yeah. And so the song kind of talks, and also talks a little bit about, as you grow up, your parents tell you things, and it sounds really trite at first, but as you get older, you say, oh, okay, that's why mom and dad told me that. It's like life is a lot harder, you know, as you get older. And also, you just kind of have to roll with the punches a little bit. And, you know, the vulnerable side, the ugly side of love is what's great about love, I think, you know?
Oh, I won't agree with that one. I don't like getting hurt. I don't like... But you've just had a baby girl.
Yeah,
she's
yeah,
5 months
daughter.
Old.
Yeah.
So what are you going to do now as regards touring? What are you going to do with... What is your daughter's name?
Her name is Nevis.
So what's Nevis going to do?
Nevis is...
going to tour with
you? Yeah, she's been touring so far. She's already been to Japan and London, New York, LA, back again. So she's been all over.
She's got a full passport already,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, full passport. It's funny because I remember your kids were the stuff of legend only. I had friends who took part in Ozfest and... they were talking about these great traveling road kids on the road, and I thought, wow, that's great. So, you know.
It's a great life experience for your kids to...
It's different.
It's very, very different. It opens their eyes, maybe to too many things, but it's a great education, and too, for them to go around the world.
Yeah.
It's like they see so much.
Yeah, yeah.
And different cultures. And
she's little right now. She's pretty portable. So, you know, as soon as she is old enough to complain about it, then we'll stop. For now, she's good. She likes
so
it.
So who takes care of her on the road when you're working?
The two of us, me and her dad. We're both musicians, so.
Yeah.
We say she's going to rebel. She's going to be an accountant.
Oh, like, probably.
Mom and dad, you're weirdos.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. She'll be like my eldest one. Totally rebel. Doesn't want anything to
really?
Do with a lifestyle.
Oh,
no.
Wow. That's cool. That's
yeah, that happens.
Yeah, yeah.
And I was reading your mum... worked at something I used to do.
Oh, you were a chambermaid too?
Yeah.
All right.
I was. And I used to love it. I was very, very young when I did it, and I used to love it because I used to like to look through people's things.
Oh my gosh.
When I was in the room.
You're a bad chambermaid.
I am. I'm.
You were bad.
Definitely.
We were
very bad.
The holy chambermaids.
We were?
No. Actually, it was kind of cool. All these people came from the prairies, and Canada's really cold, so they'd kind of flock west to be in the warm Victoria mm-hmm. weather where I grew up. And so my mom knew everyone. They'd come back probably 25 years in a row. So it was like a big family thing. So yeah, it's a rite of passage. You had to work at the, you know, at the hotel in the summertime. I started when I was 12. And I used to write a lot of songs my days at the hotel. Yeah, yeah, I would just kind of grab the little report sheet and scribble down songs. And some of those songs are on my first album, Monelli. Yeah.
That's great life experiences, right?
Oh, definitely. I'm all about that. I'm all about the real stuff. I come from really... Actually, I have a song about it on my current album called Saturdays. And I just talk about this idea of this girl kind of dreaming about the future and dreaming about a life in the music business. And just, you know, it was all good. I love that I came from that background.
It's really great. It is a really, really great CD, Folklore, okay? And it's in stores now.